Everyone, it's Let's Talk Movies, and we're back after, I don't even know, too long.
500 years.
And we've all aged considerably. Oh, yeah. Okay. Some more than others. And I'll tell you what's super exciting about this one is that we've got Baradwaj Rangan joining us from Chennai.
Buddy.
The one and only, the most amazing, the national award winning film critic who we all think is the bomb.
I love his eyebrows.
Let that be heard that she loves his eyebrows. Is he in? Do we have Baddie? No, we don't have Baddie. Okay, so when Baddie joins us, guys, he will tell us how he felt about the movies. We're first going to start with Article 15.
Yes.
What did you guys think? I liked it. I didn't love it. For me, Mulk was a far more emotionally moving experience. More emotionally engaging. I had sort of structural issues with the way it kind of panned out. But Rahul, I know you loved it.
Oh, I loved it.
Yeah. Tell us more.
I prefer this to Mulk. Because for me, Mulk was sort of, it was easier to do because, you know, you had a lawyer. So you're straight away directly addressing the audience.
Sure.
Yeah.
You know, you're hearing the things you want to hear. It's a little more cinematically easy to do.
Yeah.
Here it was more of a challenge because there's no action. You know, it's an investigative drama.
But you didn't, the exposition, hey, and Baddie's alive. Hey, Baddie.
Baddie, can you see me? You come closer to the camera.
Hey, hi. Should I come closer or?
Look at that.
So, Baddie, we've just begun the discussion on Article 15, which I liked but didn't love. Rahul really loved it. Sucharita, what did you
think? I enjoyed it very much, yes. I thought it was a very moving experience.
And you liked it also more than Mulk.
I don't know if I liked it more than Mulk. I don't think I'm not comparing it to Mulk. Actually, I have some thoughts in my head about what I thought that the climax could have been in a different matter. But overall, I quite enjoyed it. But I'm not comparing it with Mulk as a product.
Baddie, what did you think?
Of which movie?
Article 15.
Oh, sorry. There was like a setup thing going on here, so. I liked it. I think I preferred Mulk to this, but I really like it. Was a good movie. Yeah, it was a good movie. Yeah.
Yeah, I really enjoyed some of the moments that he created with, you know, sort of, it was really dramatic, the hanging of the girls and people.
This is
a fully spoiler filled conversation. So do not troll us by saying, oh, we didn't know and you ruined the movie.
Yeah.
If you haven't seen these films, stop watching us now. So the hanging of the girls, which anyway is not a spoiler, it is in the trailer. But you know, just the cinematography and the atmosphere that he built.
Yeah.
What didn't work for me as well was his relationship with his girlfriend. You know, I found that just pure exposition. Like he was just talking to her to say, okay, now I feel this, now I feel that, now I feel, you know. So for me, that was just very clumsy cinematically.
Yeah. That was a character that, you know, was just there. I felt that, you know, if we remember watching Black Klansman, which is what I said in my not a movie review also, how towards the end of the film, Spike Lee takes you to a place where he's solved the situation that he's dealing with in the film, infiltrating the KKK. But then he shows you that this is just his cinematic version of the events. The truth is far from being this rosy and this happy. So in this film also, Anupama Chopra, he solves the situation at hand and he solves this particular case. And, the IPS officer comes out victorious. But the film fails to address the reality of the situation, the grim kind of, you know, where it originates from, that this caste system is not only prevalent in like some far-flung parts of the country, it's very real. Every day you're seeing stories in the news and there's videos out there of people actually on a daily basis in the cities. So I think that is something that the movie could have addressed, in my opinion. That's where I found it lacking a little bit.
Rahul, anything more to add?
No, I mean, I thought like whatever criticism the film did get or you know, what we think are the weaknesses, which are to an extent, I mean, I get what Sucharita is saying and even you. But I thought that those exact things worked for me in the film, and I thought there was a reason behind most of the cinematic decisions in the film. Like it wasn't just the atmosphere.
Right.
Everything according to me was being looked at through the gaze of Ayushmann as a character.
Yeah.
So that's why we saw the film so cinematically so sophisticated, because that's how a person coming from a city, an upper caste person who is like us, when he goes to a village, that's how he imagines a village.
The countryside is so beautiful.
So I thought even having a character like his girlfriend and texting her and WhatsApping her, sort of made sense within that. Mm-hmm. That was because I chose to look at the film like that through his gaze.
Yeah. Right.
There were particular parts where they went away from his gaze, like for example, that there's a crucial scene where Manoj Pawa sort of kills someone.
Yeah. Yeah.
That was a problem, because that's where you go away from Ayushmann and the tone changes. You're defying your own tone.
Sort of goes into Gangs of Wasseypur territory.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. That caught me by surprise. That scene I was not expecting that.
You're defying your own tone. Individually, that scene may have been nice, you know, but it didn't work. And I actually liked how it ended, because for me it was the film came across as a tragedy. There was no happy ending.
Yeah.
It reminded me
it
of...
It was a brief respite.
It was a brief respite. Yeah. And that's up to us to understand, because Newton was the same.
Yeah.
Newton didn't change anything.
Yeah, correct.
You know, he went back to the... And the same will happen to Ayushmann's character in this film.
Yeah.
They found the girl. You have to give the audience a happy ending. There was no girl otherwise.
Yeah, there wasn't any inspired from the story.
So
yeah.
They had to put certain things, which I get.
Yeah.
But I liked how they zoomed out towards the end, and there was Mohammad Zeeshan Ayub's character, who was actually very important to the story.
Mm. Yeah.
I like that they zoomed out in the end, you know, because otherwise we'd just look at it as a police procedural.
Right.
And we'd forget
Sorry, I'm responding to the weird sounds that we're getting in the middle.
Emanating from Baddie's side.
Baddie, what's going down there?
No, it's like, it's, I mean, I'm seeing a lot of comments saying audio, but I'm also, like, I'm hearing every alternate word that you guys are saying, so I'm not sure. Like, I kind of, yeah.
But it sounds like you're murdering a cat.
Yeah, it's like I'm not really getting a... I'm seeing a comment that says, is Rahul Desai on a Kabir Singh hangover because he has...
yes, he is!
Which gives us, friends, the perfect segue into Kabir Singh.
Okay, guys, so the two of you, I know you especially hated it. You also pretty much hated it. Okay, so I enjoyed Arjun Reddy. It is, of course, problematic, as is Kabir Singh. But I bought into the love story. Eventually, it started to work for me. For me, Arjun Reddy worked better only because I didn't know Vijay Devarkonda at all, and I didn't know what I was walking into at all. Mm. So it really kind of blew me away, and he was terrific. With with Kabir Singh, there was it's a beat for beat
recreation.
So it's very hard, and still I you know, post getting over things I found extremely problematic, still got sucked into it as a love story. So guys, I totally get that that people are, you know, not into a film. What I find a little bit surprising is the suggestion that a film like this should not be made or seen. Or where does that come from? I'm curious about that, because that seems to me as extreme as positions taken on the other side, that this offends our sensibilities and therefore should never be made. Where do you think that sentiment is coming from?
You know, like Rahul said on Twitter also, like, and I really, really like what you wrote, that this film will now not remain good film or bad film. It will become extremes. Either it is your raging bull of our times, or it is the worst film ever made. Because that's just how we are reacting to cinema right now, Hindi cinema right now. You know, I immensely, immensely dislike the film. It made me extremely uncomfortable. I was sitting next to you, and I was just squirming, like physically ill at what I was seeing. I don't say that this film should not have been made or this film should have been banned.
Right.
Because that is not a road that we need to go down.
We can't.
We cannot.
Yeah,
we
yeah.
cannot. We cannot. We can't go down that road. It's a slippery slope. But having said that, you know what's happening is, since I have voiced my dissent quite emphatically, because I feel very strongly about it, what has happened is that people have taken it very personally, and the conversation has gone beyond it being a film. The conversation has now devolved into who you are as a person.
Sure.
You know, if you agree with not even the film, if you like one scene in the film or dislike one scene in the film, or have to say something about one action he did and then not don't say anything about the another action that he did, who you are as a person. And that to me is astounding. I wasn't expecting.
Right.
After my Article 15 Not a Movie review came out, I got so many messages from so many girls under the video in my inbox saying, oh, we're so happy to see that you're back because we were thinking that you're not going to come back, that you're going to stay away for a couple of weeks. And I was like, no, guys, I mean, what I did was a film review.
Right.
There is no reason for me to stay away. But that's the conversation that this film has generated, that people are now attacking for or against. And I mean, people actually expected me to go off the internet after the backlash my video got, which to me is just so surprising.
Yeah.
I wasn't expecting this.
Yeah.
That, you know, there will be people who would want me to just shut up about the film. Like, don't say anything about the film.
It happened in Uri.
This is worse.
Yeah, this is worse.
I got flack for not raving about Uri, but not this. Like, this I think the viciousness feels...
Yeah, this is worse. And I mean, in the end, you know, it's just a film. I mean, it's a cliche, but it is, and you know, it has every right to exist.
Correct.
That doesn't mean, you know, we are a nation of hyperbole. So, you know, I didn't expect people to, you know, take a middle ground with a film like this.
Right.
Same with a lot of our other films. Mm. I don't think people like to take middle ground, because middle ground means you have to actually think and, you know,
be nuanced
about things and all. And people don't have time for that.
Right.
So, you know, even though I didn't, like, I wasn't absolutely repelled by it, but I totally get why she was. But the film, apart from what was obviously problematic about it, the film just didn't work for me on a film.
Correct. It
level.
Didn't engage you emotionally.
Yeah, it didn't.
Rohit. And Baddie's back. Baddie, can you hear us?
Now, finally, yes. After about 3 earphone changes and something else, I'm finally able to join the conversation.
Okay, Baddie, give us your view on Arjun Reddy, because I think you haven't seen Kabir Singh. Is that correct?
Yeah, because the only reason I didn't watch it is because there's a Tamil remake coming up in a few months, and I didn't want to watch this. And that was, I mean, already that's such a strong movie that it's I still remember bits of it, and I really didn't want it to see it all over again. And then so that movie becomes very stale when I watch it. So that's the only reason. But I do want to watch how Shahid has like played the role, because. That's interesting, and I want to see. There are some people who say it's a frame by frame remake, and there are some people who say there are things that are missing. So I'm not sure which is right.
Baddie, it's literally, I think, like a scene where, you know, he talks about objectifying air hostesses. That's the one that's missing. And I'm trying to think. There's another scene where the friend comes to give him the invitation card, and Arjun talks about the kind of connection him and Preeti had, and still they didn't get a happy ending, and what right does he have? As far as I remember, that's not in Kabir Singh. There is the invitation card, but not that whole other bit
it. Okay.
You know, but other than that, I think it's pretty much a frame to frame. Did you see both?
I haven't seen it already.
Oh, you haven't seen? Okay. Yeah. Okay, so you didn't know what was coming.
No, I was not prepared.
Oh, yeah. Right.
I was not prepared for this.
Okay.
But Sucharita, first, congratulations on the 1 million. It's a big deal, and I'm so happy that it happened finally.
Thanks, buddy. 2 million on Facebook.
Really. Yeah. Sorry?
2 million on Facebook. I'm sorry. Go on.
Oh, yeah, and all that. So. So, no, but one thing that really surprises me is that this film has become the equivalent of what, of what Bush said. It's like, you're either with us or against us. You know, it's just like, there have been many, many, many films, some that I have liked and some that I have not liked. And you know, films that I've said things that I agree with and things that I've not agreed with and whatever it is. But after a very long time, and I actually cannot remember what was the last time that such a thing happened, after a very long time, I'm seeing a movie where the people on this side, that is the people that say, yes, this is about a problematic guy, but this is not a problematic movie, are saying that if you do not see that, then that's like, you know, they're attacking people like Sucharita. And when on the other side, well, you know, where people that agree with Sucharita are attacking people like me, because they're like, why can't you see that, you know, this is such a problematic film, and because you can't see, your gaze is problematic and this and that. And I'm like, it's almost become a way of evaluating the person, which is always part of the course, because it's like, you know, every review is a bit of an autobiography. So we review films through our lenses and prisms and all these things. So through the things that we find acceptable, tolerable, not tolerable. But beyond that, it also tells a lot about us as a people, because there are some reviewers that will take their ideological stance into the review and they'll say, you know, that this should not happen, right? Whereas, you know, I'm on the other side where I will say, and that should be there, because, you know, you need strong ideologically defined reviews as well. But my personal take, which is what I've been doing from the beginning, is to say, well, whether I like it or not, let me see what happens on screen and see how that character has been handled or whatever it is. But so far, it hasn't been so much of a problem. But in this particular case, it's become almost like, how can you see it your way? How can you not see it the other way? You know, and that's been very interesting to handle, because it's almost like it's become a way of marking who you are. And you're on this side of the fence or in that side of the fence, and at the end of the day, this is no longer just a movie. It's something that almost that's reinforcing in people the kind of person that you are. And I'm finding that the most interesting aspect of this film, more than the film itself, because there have been films earlier that have come out with all kinds of problematic things, but you know, I've been talking to people about this. It's like in a journalism class, this came up. What if, you know, there was a person, that boy who, you know, after seeing Agnipath, took a pair of scissors and stabbed his teacher. And there was this person who, you know, like, there have been very, very violent movies that have inspired all sorts of things. There have been, there was that person inspired by the Batman movie, and I think what, he blew up a theater or tried to blow up a theater or something.
Something weird
happened there. I'm not like something happened there. So, like, but this is kind of like, it's become a way of testing your gaze. Like, for instance, when I remember A.O. Scott, when he, or somebody else, they did not like the Avengers movie. Was that A.O. Scott?
Yes, it was A.O. Scott.
He was attacked that he was not in tune with popular culture, which that is, you know, that was a different thing, because, you know, yes, of course, A.O. Scott is an older person and not like probably an Avengers generation person in terms of this particular Avengers series of movies. But this has really been interesting. It's been, I think, the first time I have seen something like that. Rahul, have you seen anything like that before, like this before? Or like Sucharita, have you seen anything like this before?
I was just talking. I mean, the last movie that reminded me of this reaction was Uri, yeah. But for different reasons. It was there, it was either you're patriotic or you're not patriotic. And propaganda.
Oh, if you like the film or not, okay.
Yeah, so it became ugly there. And I kind of expected it to happen with this film. That's the sad part. I don't know how much that says that we expect these things now. As soon as I watched Arjun Reddy, I had a feeling that viewers in the Hindi film circuit in the rest of the country will react will react in extremes to a film like this. And when I saw it, all the backlash we got after that, I'm really not surprised.
You know, it's also when a super villain inspires one person to do something tragic and do something horrible, that's a different thing. But here, the person that is being portrayed by Shahid Kapoor, Kabir Singh, is not a super villain. He's a regular guy who, we know people like this exist, and when the bad things that this character does at the end of the film are rewarded, that a lot of people want to become, you know, because you don't need a, because people are saying, are gangs of Vazaipur dekh ke maine logon ka murder to nahi kar diya jaake, because you're not in gangs of Vazaipur, you are in a city, and you know, this character lives a life that you're familiar with. Of course this character is going to influence people, and that's what has happened. And people are saying, you know, movies don't influence people. Like, I don't even want to acknowledge that sentiment that movies don't influence people. They do. They do. What's been happening on social media for a week is insane. It's like an out-of-body experience for me. Like, I can't even believe I'm in the eye of the storm in that, you know, this is all coming at me. I feel like I'm looking at it from the outside. The way people are reacting to this film and the way people are reacting to reviews like Rahul's and myself. Because I don't even know, you know, why everybody's feeling so strongly about this film. Because like we said, it's, at the end of the day, it's a film. Why are we making it so like who you are as a person?
Yeah, and you know, it's not a sort of mark of character. You know what I mean? It's very strange. Okay, let's take some comments. Okay. Siddhant Preeti says, how disturbed are you by Bollywood's reaction to Kabir Singh? By Bollywood's reaction?
I don't know. What's
tweets, I guess. Tweets and congratulatory messages and posts and things like that.
Par for the course, I mean,
not all of it is genuine.
Of course not. Of course not.
Most of it is ingenuine.
I don't think half the people actually mean what they send.
No, they don't.
It's just like, you know, so.
They don't mean what they say. This is just, it has to be done. It's another form of networking. Yeah.
Even in Chennai, I've seen a lot of people, they come out of a movie and they've hated it, but the next day they'll like discuss with half an hour about how they hated it, but the next day there'll be like this tweet going out saying, congratulations, this amazing work by everyone, and everyone will be tagged in that, you know, just kind of.
You know, Karan Johar had told me once about how he has two tweets, one if he likes the film and one if he doesn't like the film. Because even the one when he doesn't like the film has to sound like he liked the film. So, you know, it's very important. Okay, then there's somebody called Siddhesh Maekar who says, what about Wolf of the Wall Street? Wasn't the protagonist also misogynistic, toxic masculinity, abusing the power of money? He also got away with gentle punishment. Please comment.
There's so please many comment. Of these.
I have a feeling we've gone through all this many, many times. You know, this kind of...
There is so many of this. There's people saying, what about Devdas? What about Ranjana? What about this and what about that? You know, what about Urta Punjab?
See, I think you have to understand that everyone comes from the place that a review that is coming out from me or Rahul or Sucharita is, or Anupama, is a reflection of what we feel about certain things, just like the commenter to any of these reviewers feels very hold those positions about the movie. So I don't think anybody can, this, when you say what about like thing, I feel this way that Wolf of Wall Street is very similar to Arjun Reddy because of XYZ reasons, but that doesn't mean that you guys have to hold the same position, because for you, you may see differently, or the commenter may see differently. But I'm saying that while you're reading my review, that's the position. It's not an endorsement. It's not like me telling that you should see it this way. Right. It's more like I see it this way. That, I mean, I don't know if I'm making that clear. It's like, so the thing is, like anything, it's even if it's just a like one person, it's just that one person saying that. It's not saying Arjun Reddy is the unspoken thing in every review is like every sentence is preceded by IMO. In my opinion, this is what it is.
Correct.
Because you can't keep writing IMO in front of every line. That's, you don't write it. But it's basically just that one person's hopefully well-argued point of view. But that endorsement aspect of it, which leads to such questions as, like, what about this film? It's good discussion. It's a good discussion to have. But I'm saying that at the end of the day, it is still like going to vary with many people, because each one is going to come up with a different point of view of how this is similar to that movie or this is not similar to that movie because of X, Y, Z reasons. So, I mean, I don't know.
I also feel it's apples and oranges. You can't compare Wolf of Wall Street with Kabir Singh. You know, you want to look at Wolf of Wall Street, you look at it separately. You want to look at Devdas, you look at it separately. It's not, you can't compare that with Kabir Singh. It's an entire different film, entire different social context, entire different, you know, people who is watching it and whatever. Like, Wolf of Wall Street was also poking fun at, you know, America and the kind of people that become heroes in America, the kind of corrupt people who can become heroes in America. That was the whole gaze of the film. It's a whole different thing entirely. So I
no, but I sort of have a question for actually every one of us too, because at least a film like this gets me thinking. I mean, according to me, a film like this, at least at some level, I was thinking, like, even though it is a personal opinion, it sort of comes from a place of how we've been brought up, what kind of environment we've been in all our lives, which is why when people are, I think, judging reactions to the film and they are saying, that if you sort of like the film, that means you somewhere deep inside endorse this behavior and it's not a problem to you. Or if you dislike the film, you are a feminist or whatever shit they come up with, at least the reaction to the reactions. I wonder if this film also at some level does reveal your own personality in the way we sort of react to, because according to me every film does, you know, like I react to an animated film differently, I react to a patriotic film differently, my own sense of politics does factor in, and it should. And I feel like this, which talks...
No,
which
it's is, not that it should, it will.
It will, it will.
And I mean, you said it will, it will.
So I was wondering if this film, which is not, which doesn't deal with politics, and it's a more personal film, and it deals with morality, it deals with a lot of sort of human things, you know, it's. I wonder if that sort of reveals the kind of person you are when you react to this film, because I don't think there's an easy answer to that, because I do think that when I do dislike this film particularly, and when I'm saying that, you know, Arjun Reddy is a problematic character, I do think that is because somewhere down the line I've seen these characters and I've hated these characters, and I've had friends like that, I've had people around me in my family like that, and that if I like them, that means at some point I might have been pushed by them into thinking that that isn't toxic enough. So I do think there is some kind of argument there. I just don't think it's come out very well from the reactions, because they have been rabid most of the time. I do think that
that's
it
the
does
problem reveal. That the reactions also extreme. The everything is just extreme. No one's able to have a conversation.
Yeah, yeah.
You know,
but that's the kind of provocative film they've made.
They wanted extreme.
They wanted the extreme reactions. It's not mellow. Yeah. In any way, if there are women who are saying that we felt unsafe watching the film in the theater when there's two girls and 10 men around us applauding and cheering at all the wrong moments, when Preeti is getting slapped and when Preeti is getting pushed around and the men are applauding, and women are saying we felt uncomfortable watching the film. Who?
Truthfully, that didn't happen with me. Huh? I saw it in a hall, like, In a regular place with regular people.
But you and I come from a very high place of safety and privilege and everything.
No, of course we do. But I'm saying that's not true of every hall, everywhere.
Sure.
And I didn't, I mean, I saw Arjun Reddy, so like I said, I knew every beat that was coming. But I didn't get a sense that people were applauding when she got slapped, you know.
They were when we were watching.
So you guys were in a press show.
Yeah, the press show, there were two or three guys who did applaud it, which is interesting, because I in Arjun Reddy, like if you noticed in Kabir Singh, the moment after he does slap her, which was obviously the most popular scene of the film according to in Arjun Reddy, there is actually a background score that starts the moment he slaps her.
Right.
And it's sort of a playful background score.
Hmm.
And, you know, I actually wanted to ask you, Badi, if, you know, in Arjun Reddy, that particular scene after he slaps her, there's a background score that starts, and that background score is not there in the Hindi film. And it's that background score that sort of drove a lot of people over the edge, even while watching Arjun Reddy, that this is the director's gaze. He thinks this is a funny scene, or he thinks this is a stylish scene. And as we know, the background score goes a long way in sort of defining our language in Hindi and cinema in Indian cinema, in manipulating our emotions. So, I mean, it was interesting to see there was no background score in the Hindi film. I wanted to know your take on that particular scene, about why Arjun Reddy would have that and say something like Kabir Singh wouldn't, because that was the scene that sort of triggered a lot of reaction in the audience.
I don't know, frankly, Rahul, because I don't remember that the background score on that scene well enough. I saw it maybe a year and a half ago, maybe 2 years ago. So I'm not. Was it a 2017 movie?
Yeah, it's 2017.
Yeah, 17. So yeah, so I don't recall the score or how it was, but let me come back to that point where you said it reveals like things about ourselves, right? Whether I think there's one thing that we should consider, that some people are able to without judging either side, again, because, you know, there are, like, just like earlier we said, I think some people are, you know, are are able to dissociate a story from its impact on society or whatever it is and view it as just a story. And for other people, it is not that way. Because for me, it's always like I'll go back to the example that I give out every time in kind of thing. It's like is Lolita is a book that could not be written today. Okay, it is one of the most magnificent books I've ever read. I go back and reread it every time I'm stuck for inspiration. It's one of the books that I go back and read a few passages from every time I'm stuck, because it's such a like a beautifully written book. I'm saying that it's one of the most repugnant subjects of that one can ever have, which is about an older man seducing his stepdaughter and marrying her mother for the sake of being with her. And throughout, the prose glorifies this man or lets him off easy, because we never hate him. We never hate this man. We always like this man. We always like amused by this man, by his contempt for norms of society and things like that. We always are with this man. Now, yes, that book was written long, long ago, and you know, the thing was different then. But I don't think that even at that time, people were actively, nobody was endorsing the subject matter. It was a very, very controversial book. But today, despite all that, it's become a classic. And you may not consider it a classic, but what I'm saying is only for me, that's the kind of thing. I'm not comparing Lolita to the book to this movie. I'm just saying that for me, the philosophy of using silken language to couch the reprehensible actions of a horrible man, a clearly horrible man, is not very different from using powerful filmmaking to couch the or using a very charismatic star to kind of put across certain things that would otherwise be problematic. Is raping a minor problematic? Nobody's going to say no. But there are many, many people who think Lolita is one of the greatest examples of 20th century fiction. And without saying that everyone should think the same way, I think we should allow for the fact that some people can think this, can hate, can be completely, thinking that people who rape children should be maybe even hanged, but be okay with Lolita as a piece of fiction. So I'm saying that for me, that is the kind of logic that I don't consciously apply. See, that's the point. It's not like I'm consciously applying this logic and all that. But when I think back about my reaction to what it is, I see it as that kind of a thing where I'm looking at the story of a problematic dude and how he thrashes about after not getting the thing, because that, you know, he's for him, the first he sees the girl like a toy, and then he slowly mellows, and for him that becomes his journey. Now if you buy this journey, then I think you buy the movie. If you don't buy that journey, and I think you don't buy the
exactly.
movie. I don't know, that's the way
yeah.
I see it.
Yeah. That's it. I mean, but that's true, you know, of any movie. I think if you buy the journey, then you stop looking for logic and whether it's, what the politics are or what the politics are not. I think if you don't buy into the journey, then it all just comes out. I mean, I remember, what was the Amir movie? Gajni. I remember watching that and I didn't buy into that love story at all. You know, so that film, despite the 300 crores that it did or whatever it did, I just couldn't see that, like, I couldn't connect emotionally with any of it. I just think that it's true. If you don't buy the journey, then you don't buy it. And I, like you, Baddy, don't go into films with an ideology. For me, it's always about whether the film works or doesn't work. You know, it's not enough to have good intentions or it's not enough to have bad intentions. So I think...
Just please finish.
No, so that's it. You know, so for me, because I bought into the journey, I stayed with the film.
No, and also personal life plays so much a part of this, because as a guy, I have never faced the kind of violence that some women have faced. Now, so when I look at this, I look at it from my viewpoint of how I see Arjun and how I see Preeti as fictional characters. Now, had I been a woman and had I actually been through something like that, my whole, like the way I look at Arjun Reddy might have been very different. So, or if I had been a guy and I had somebody in my family that was treated the same way or something like that, which is not to say that, you know, it's only when it happens close to you or to you, it is, but I'm saying that if something like that has affected you at a personal level, even if it's a newspaper report or whatever it is, if it has struck you, then maybe the dissociation between it's just a film or something else, because I remember a film that I saw once, I'm not naming the film, it's about a person's relationship with his dad, and I was not, like, I had some problems with the movie, but this friend I saw this movie with, he was sobbing non-stop. And he really, really loved the movie because he just lost his father, you know, some time back. And this whole movie was playing out like in that zone of his being. So, I mean, it's an intensely personal thing, I think. And also how you think, which is why, see, when I say I don't bring my, it's not that I don't bring my ideology to a movie, Anu. It's just that I've never let, like, I'm a, like I'm just saying, like I said for Lolita, I don't like what is being done, or rather I don't like the, I'm not for the that action, but I'm for the fact that somebody can write a book about it and write about it in such an exquisite manner that we don't really feel the repercussions on either the girl or the guy.
But Maddie, that's not the conversation this film has generated at all. You know, anybody who's
But I don't know. I got a lot of feedback saying, like, you know, what about the you know, don't see the repercussions on the guy or the girl. You know, that's where I was coming from. Anyway, please continue.
The conversation is not that you shouldn't make movies about these bad boys and these problematic characters. Obviously, I mean, that's just a very basic, you know, that's not something that we're saying anyway. Obviously, you make whatever movie that you want to make. It's just the conversations and the actions and the everything that this film has inspired since it's released, which has caught me by surprise. I was expecting there will be very strong reactions to people who will like it and people who will not like it. But the way it's almost like the people who've really bought into the film and loved the film, and mostly men who've loved the film, it's vicious. Their love for this film is vicious.
I have to tell you though, I met a woman this morning. I had a meeting, a very sort of high-powered woman at a television channel, who said, "I really loved it. I just can't say it in public."
Pretty much said that.
I'm like, shouldn't be the case. You know, it's strangely, you shouldn't be ashamed of shit you like. Yeah, it's okay. It's fine.
No, and strangely, my video to this, when I did this video kind of last week, the person who said it was a great video and thank you for doing this was a woman. And today, a guy, the person who criticized that video and point by point took down everything was a guy. So again, yeah. You know, that's interesting for me that the endorsement came from a woman and the criticism came from the guy. So, you know, it's also...
Well...
Rahul, please stop. How did you decide to grow this beard after... How much did the Kabir Singh character enter you?
So, I couldn't say this in public, right? Because we can't. But no, personally, I mean, sticking only to the film and like for a second distancing ourselves from the reactions, I thought, look, I love films about problematic characters. You know, I love Ranbir Kapoor characters in every film. I love that he's a toxic man-child in most of his films, and I think he does it better than anyone else. But personally,
yeah, you like Tamasha, didn't you?
Oh, I love Tamasha.
I love Tamasha.
I love him in Adil and Mushkil too. You know, so I see, look, it's not that because I relate to those characters, I just love how he does it. And
sure.
I have also then, a film like Kabir Singh got me thinking that does this say something about me that I love all these characters? Does it say something about my ideology, about the way maybe I'm like this? But, you know, I think deep inside, I sort of, as we all like to sort of separate the narrative and the story and the filmmaking, I sort of ended up liking most of them because none of them really do have a happy ending in any of their movies. I didn't know that, subconsciously I didn't know that till a film like Kabir Singh came and started, you know, having like a very roomy kind of narration of the first and the last scene, them on the beach,
yeah.
You know, this is a beautiful love story. And yeah. I was like, no, it's not a beautiful love
Kabir,
story, it's
yeah.
a tragedy.
Exactly.
Okay. Them ending up together is a tragedy. If only the filmmaker had noticed that, it would have actually turned this into a very mature film.
Yeah.
I just thought that, you know, it was reflected in the filmmaking.
Yeah.
The immaturity of the characters reflected in the filmmaking. Most of Ranbir Kapoor's characters or any toxic masculinity film, most of them are tragedies. And all of them that at least personally I have loved have been tragedies. I've never looked at it that way. I didn't know that they were tragedies. Still a film like this came and slapped me on my face saying, you know, this is why you like those films and you can't like a film like this. Because, you know, they are lying on the beach at the end of the movie.
Mm.
And you know, whatever, I mean, he was redeemed in a way. I mean, sure,
in a way, in every
job.
Way.
Sure, he lost his job, you know, sure. But you know, you're not supposed to go beyond that. I'm not, that's where, you know, your personal views start coming into a film. And they should, you know, because this is directly an element of the filmmaking, if you're thinking about that. Because, like, whatever the people, the names they're throwing around, Wolf of Wall Street is a tragedy. Devdas is a tragedy. Any Ranbir Kapoor film, Raging Bull, you know, stop throwing names at us, like, because all of them, if you notice, all of them, the filmmakers recognize what
yes.
they are saying.
Yes.
And they are... they are making beautiful films, beautiful filmmaking, beautiful language like Lolita. That is also a tragedy.
Yes.
And that's what is different. I know it's simplistic to say that, you know, a character like this should not be redeemed. But, you know, the filmmaker has to notice that.
Mm.
The filmmaker has to notice that because we can go and I could have really liked this film if I had decided to like it.
Mm.
Because, you know, he's my favorite character. He's lashing out at everyone.
Mm.
You know,
yeah.
I don't care if he slapped her or he's, you know, he's being abusive towards women. People like that exist.
Yep.
We see it every day.
Yep.
But the filmmaker doesn't realize.
Yep.
And
that's the problem. The problem is not that you're showing a character who slaps his girlfriend or a girl who's tragically attracted to this man also, because
these are
two idiots.
Yeah.
They are in love with each other. Let them get destroyed with each other. The problem is when you're playing romantic songs, when he goes and he meets her for the first time and kisses her in first meeting and you play a romantic ballad in the background, that's what makes me so uncomfortable, because you're normalizing this. You know, and it's not normal. It's wrong, and don't eulogize it.
Yeah, for sure. Those
That's
things.
What made me just like, oh my gosh, are you serious?
That I sensed.
Ye love story hai. You know, I mean, Urta Punjab dekh lo yaar, aap Shahid Kapoor ke usme bhi ganda ladka tha wo. But when everybody shouting around him, who's the gabru, that's not his victory cry. That is Abhishek Chaubey's gaze at looking at this, look at him, is an idiot. He's destroying himself. And then if you want to redeem a character like that, like they did in Urta Punjab, you give him a redemption that is worth, that is, you know, the kind of shit that he's done. He saves that girl's life. And it's Alia Bhatt's win at the end of the film. He stands in the back and helps her win at the end of the film. It doesn't become about him and how he has overcome all the problems that he's had in his life, and he gets the girl and he gets all the riches and everything. That's a redemption arc I will buy into.
All I can say is I bought into it. It was very funny. in the middle of the film.
I'm going to go.
At one point he says to somebody, shut up! And I recognize that, I turned to Mohini, who I was watching it with. I'm like, holy shit, it's Vinod. And I realize, I'm like, I live with somebody who has anger management problems, and therefore I can completely connect with this. This is the truth, you're right. It's, if personally you can connect with it, you connect with it.
Unlike Rahul, I don't see Wolf of Wall Street as a tragedy. I see it as a comedy. Martin Scorsese saw it as a comedy, and I think that's what bugged Peter Bradshaw when he wrote a review in The Guardian, because he's saying that we don't see any of the repercussion of this man's big schemes on the young, on the people. We don't see any of the people that were affected by his Ponzi schemes or whatever. And, you know, you just see him getting high and high and high on life. And he suffers, sure,
yeah,
and all that kind of stuff. But that's pretty much the same arc. And at the end, you know, he gets away with literally like a rap on the knuckles kind of thing. So I think it's kind of a satire kind of thing. Of course, it's different from the tone of Arjun Reddy, but that's one thing. Tamasha again is a happy ending. Those two guys kind of get each other.
It's
the second
satirical,
thing is,
yeah.
I don't want movies to be guided by moral forces. I don't want, if a guy does something wrong, I don't want him not, like saying, acha, isne bura kiya, so he should not get a redemption. I don't see movies like that, okay? And I fully respect, like everybody's going to see the movies differently. But I'm saying that the most horrible person can have a happy ending, and that's that story, that particular director, or that particular story writer chose that, okay? And the way I see Kabir Singh is the way I read, it reminded me of stories like Wuthering Heights, for instance, where this mad man and this mad woman, they find peace only when they are with each other, but when they're away from each other, you know, they're just like, each one is tormented and tormented and tormented, and that it's only when they are together that they get the feeling like Kabir and Shalini do when they're lying on the beach in that bed or whatever it is. That's exactly what Wuthering Heights is. Of course, that's a different story, like beyond a certain point. But what I'm saying is that mad passion, that's what we call Byronic love, right? It's like, it's basically that whole romantic era thing, which I think maybe not, like, people today don't identify with it at all. I don't know, because that whole Byronic passion with which you literally, like, you're together or you're nothing. You're like either with this other person and they calm all the tempests inside you, or you're like raging with all these, you know, with these feelings or whatever. So I saw it like that. And again, you know, see, one of the things that I always like when a movie like this comes out is, see, I put out a review or a thoughts. It's always nice to see how other people whose voices you respect respond to it, but without saying who's right or who's wrong. You know, like I can say, maybe, like, I can say in this particular case, I don't exactly agree with what Rahul and Sucharita wrote, but that doesn't mean that their point of view is wrong. It just means that I don't see it the way that they do, but there are other movies that I have been in line with what they have said, and vice versa. Like, you know, what I'm saying about this movie is probably not, like, in line with how they see it at all, but I hope that they're interested in what I'm saying. But that shouldn't be the way to say that one way is right and one way is wrong, is what I'm saying. And I think that this boils down to whether how much do you want movies to have morality. And I'm of the viewpoint that movies can be as amoral as they want. The director can be as amoral as he wants. And yes, there are people who say that, yeah, that's very good for advanced societies, and, you know, like, you know, but we are not yet there, and therefore we need some kind of thing. But I'm not the person to make that decision. I mean, if there is a higher body that wants to make this decision, like, go ahead. But for my movie consumption or my art consumption, I will not be the one making these decisions as to this is moral, this is immoral, this is people should see this, people should not see this. That I feel very uncomfortable. It's not that I don't. Like, I feel very uncomfortable making those calls, is what I'm saying.
Totally. I'm with you on this. And guys, any last words as we move on?
I mean, isn't this a session where we usually take questions from, like, what's coming up? Or is not that?
We
is
have,
it? Is it like a...
The only thing is we've gone for an hour.
Hum bahut der se bol rahe hain.
And yeah, we've gone on and on for an hour. And I feel like we could go on and keep going for another hour, because of exactly this. It's a personal view, and there is, it's a movie, it's not a fact, it's an opinion, so there's no right and wrong on this.
You know, it's so sad, people are saying you are so brave for saying what you have to say. I'm like, one shouldn't have to be brave to really disagree with each other about a film that they've seen, you know. It's just it's upsetting,
but that's the world we live in, guys. In on Twitter, it's you're for me or you're against
me. And I really think, you know, social media has made things worse, because it's kind of, there's a sense of, I don't know, like groups, you know, like people who want to be on sides or whatever it is. So instead of a discussion, we land straight into a judgment.
Yep.
And you're not actually engaging with somebody on something, which is impossible on Twitter anyway, I feel, because I don't have the patience to have long arguments on Twitter. But I'm saying it just jumps right into, oh, Sucharita is this, oh, I'm this, oh, Rahul. That doesn't help, you know, anybody. It's just like, it just becomes like something that somebody is saying, and I doubt that anybody actually gains something from this other than just venting for a bit.
That's what social media is for, vent away.
Yeah, and I'm really sorry that people feel so threatened by Sucharita's opinion that they have to write what they feel in such ridiculous words. That you know, it says more about them obviously than what you know, like, because your response is like, it's possible to disagree with what Sucharita is saying or Rahul is saying and still, you know, maintain civility in that whole thing, but to kind of, you know, get into that is so not done, and I don't know, just like it's all kinds of weird. So I'm sorry you had to go through that. So
thanks, buddy. Yeah, I was telling her, don't read comments. Right, Rahul?
Yeah, yeah.
Hi, but it's not even comments, it's everywhere. I pick up my phone, I have to put my phone on airplane mode to go to sleep now. Yeah.
Sucharita, that's the price of fame.
Ganta fame, buddy. Kaika fame. Kaika fame.
Guys, as we wrap, can I just say that we love to talk about movies and we should all talk and disagree and agree. But like Baddy said, let's keep it civil. You know, let's show some grace, because what's the point of, where does insulting people come into a narrative about when all we're talking about is movies and we all love the movies. So my request to all the happy people who've been watching us, the Kabir Singh lovers and the Kabir Singh haters, is let's keep the discourse civilized. Let's make the world a better place. Yes?
Sure. Okay.
Yep. Thank you. Bye.
Peace out.